Over the last 200 years, the Appalachians have been significantly impacted by natural resource extraction, including mining and timbering. Here is our story of how the Nature Conservancy is working with partners to help restore degraded lands and forest connections across the Appalachians.
The Appalachian region is incredibly important. You know, the forests here are biodiverse. We have some of the most biodiverse amphibian and crustacean populations in the world. And in terms of climate change, retaining these forests is crucial.
Part of what makes Central Appalachia so unique is that we have the northernmost extent of the southern species here colliding with the southernmost of the northern species here.
We've got large tracts of contiguous forest, which are important for the megafauna that still reside in this region.
And these forests once extended widely across the globe. But half of these forests have been cleared, and what remains is fragmented.
Since the early 1980s through the early 2000s, mining companies converted hundreds of thousands of acres across the Appalachian region from biodiverse forests into these non-native grasslands.
And so over the last century, this landscape, Central Appalachia, have been heavily altered by resource extraction.
And in some cases, we haven't been that gentle on nature when we've extracted those resources. We've compacted the soil and we've taken more than nature can very quickly be resilient to it.
So beyond coal mining, the forests of the eastern United States and globally are under a lot of threats from deforestation, forest fragmentation, biodiversity loss, development, invasive pests and pathogens. You know, we've lost one major tree species almost every decade for the 19th century.
Together, we're restoring former mine lands from the Allegheny Front in Pennsylvania to spruce forests in the highlands of West Virginia, to dry oak hickory forests in Kentucky and Tennessee.
The Nature Conservancy is the only conservation organization working in every state across the Appalachian landscape.
We bring science to the table, we bring funding where we can, and are excited to empower our partners to bring our restoration vision to life.
A holistic approach to reforestation on this site requires removing the unwanted vegetation, the invasive exotic species, ripping up that compacted ground to loosen it so that the trees can grow to their full potential, then sowing native wildflowers and native warm season grasses to benefit pollinators, insects, and birds, and then planting a diverse mix of native trees and shrubs across the site.
Last year we planted about 250,000 red spruce, 250,000. We'll plant probably close to 200,000 red spruce this year, but that's really just one of, you know, dozens of species that are being planted.
When the Nature Conservancy and our partners are designing conservation strategies, restoration strategies, we're thinking about the whole ecosystem.
So it's really about more than just sticking trees in the ground, because part of what we're trying to accomplish here is building the soil back up that can support a more biodiverse array of species.
If a species habitat is broken into little pieces, it can't, you know, a salamander's not going to be able to crawl, you know, 5 miles to the north to the next patch of spruce. So a lot of our restoration efforts is focused on connectivity.
We who are living downstream of this restored site are also receiving the benefits in cleaner air, cleaner water, and reduced flooding risk.
The only thing I can say, whenever we plant trees, it's a good investment. That will help with the global warming, and it's the best we can do.
They've planted over 60 species of trees and woody shrubs, and that's unprecedented. I don't know of any other ecosystem restoration work where there's so much effort that's going into finding, collecting, assembling as many pieces as going into the forest restoration work here. It's really exciting.
We really have an opportunity to recover lands that matter for generations.
As I walk around these areas and I see the oaks and shortleaf pine growing, I see the flowers blooming, I know that in 60 and 80 years, we're going to have a biodiverse, thriving forest on this land again.
The restoration community and the Appalachians has accomplished a lot, but there's still so much to be done. We're inspired by the nearly 1 million acres that is still left to be restored.
We've made incredible strides in reforesting the Appalachians and reconnecting the natural corridors for numerous plants and animals, but there is still so much to do. Will you join us in restoring these lands for a healthy, resilient, and connected Appalachians where people and nature thrive?